Hey guys, this is Allie, and this is the YNR chat vlog for Saturday, July 19th. And poor Sabrina. I feel sorry for her. I really do. I feel like she got screwed over this week. I mean, she really just got caught in the crossfire of the ongoing Victor and Jack feud, and I can't help but just feel bad for her right now. I mean, she had good intentions. I do think that she came into town, or she has been approaching this relationship with Victor from a standpoint of, let's try to heal the family. She did the article in Restless Style in the first place because it was Nyx Magazine, and because she thought it would be something, you know, she thought it was going to be something positive, and it turned into just, oh God, just a complete, what do they call it, hatchet job. And I just felt so very sorry for her. I was proud of her, though, for going to the luncheon, for showing her face, for keeping her head held high, and for going out and meeting the public. And that's really not easy for her to do. I mean, now she's got reporters that are on her constantly. Jana's, like, fighting them off at the coffee house with her pocketbook, which is pretty hilarious. But I feel really bad for her. She's got a lot of tough times ahead. And I think that this is also disappointing because it seemed like Sabrina and Victoria were starting to get their relationship back on track. They had kind of decided to put some of their differences aside earlier on in the week, and now this. And what I don't understand is why Victoria isn't really upset that she was quoted out of context in the article. Because if it was me and something I had said had been taken out of context or overheard, even if I didn't like Sabrina, even if, you know, I was secretly happy that it happened, I would still want to insist on my, you know, innocence, or my, you know, having not played a role in it, which is why I'm very shocked with Victoria. She seems almost kind of like, meh, you know, so my quotes were included in there, so I was quoted out of context. You know, she's not taking it as a very big deal, and I don't understand. I'm just thinking from my perspective, I would want Sabrina to know that I didn't play an active role in it. And maybe that's just me. Because I think in general, both Nick and Victoria were very kind of blasé about it. I mean, Victor approached Nick, and Nick was just basically, he couldn't have cared less. Victoria's really not doing anything to kind of say that she feels bad about it. I mean, I think that both Nick and Victoria and Nikki are secretly glad that it happened, which is sad. I don't know. I just kind of feel like even though there is a rift in the family, I'm very surprised that they didn't at least try to make Victor understand that this wasn't something that that they did intentionally. And now Victor's cutting them out of the will. So that's what you get. I mean, all it really would have had to take was a little bit of sympathy on Nick and Victoria's part, and perhaps this entire being cut out of the will thing could have been avoided. I mean, I'm not surprised about that, because I think Victor had been thinking about it for a while. He was asking Michael quite a while ago about potentially getting, making some changes to the will. We didn't know at the time what they were. I guess maybe I was assuming it was something to do with the new baby, but well, now Nick and Victoria get nothing. And on top of that, Nick is getting kicked off the ranch. So say bye-bye to the horsies, Nick. Your days are definitely numbered. I'm curious to see how Nick is going to react to that. It sounds like Victor's security guard bum-rushed him right at the door, and he's going to have to pack his bags. Yikes. Major tension. The tension is worse than ever in the Newman family. We'll see how this plays out. I mean, this is random, but, you know, I guess the person that I feel the worst for, even more than Sabrina in a way, is I feel really bad for Adrian. That guy, I've said many times, doesn't exactly do it for me, but yeah, I feel really bad for him. What is his reaction going to be when he returns and finds out that Jack did this to his article and his name? I mean, his career is so over, so over. Jack is a snake. He is a snake. I mean, he went to all that trouble to try to get Adrian out of town so that he couldn't, I don't know, I guess explode or corroborate anybody's story. Jack, he's gone too far, in my opinion. I mean, I guess that's the question. Did Jack do wrong? If printing the alternate article on Sabrina saved Restless Style, sold some magazines, the question is, was it wrong? And, I mean, I think it's a good question, and I am curious to know what you guys are thinking. Does the end justify the means? And I think that it's particularly interesting because Restless Style and Jabot and the other companies that Jack has worked for, they're corporations and they're their own entities. And corporations, by definition, are like people. They're sole entities, only they're people without any kind of emotion or moral conscience. And I think that it's an interesting little twist on there, because if Jack was operating in the function of, I am a contributor to this magazine and it's my duty to make sure that it succeeds no matter what, then Jack was right. But if you look at it from more of a Nick point of view, the end doesn't justify the means, and who you are in business is the same as who you are in personal. I think that Jack wants to compartmentalize. I think he wants to say, well, I did it for the magazine. It wasn't something that I necessarily would have done for personal reasons, but which is false anyway, because he absolutely did it to get back at Victor. But you know, I just think it's interesting. I'm curious to know kind of where you guys fall on that debate. Was Jack wrong or was Jack right? Feel free to leave some comments. I always read them. I always love them, and I'm curious to know what your opinion is on that. But it just looks like, all in all, Restless Style is headed down the tubes. I hate to say it, because it's been a fun venture, but I don't know. I mean, Nick wants Jack out, but not if Jack gets Nick out first. So it's definitely going to be a rush to find out, which one of those guys can get out first. It seems that Nick is not going to be able to afford to get Jack out, so I really don't know how that's going to end up resolving itself. But now Victor is going to sue. He's going to pull all of the advertising, and I mean, financially, I don't know that Restless Style would be able to recover from this anyway, which makes me wonder. I mean, Jack, was this even planned out? You knew that Victor was going to retaliate, and even if he had made it so that the article was legally tight, Newman is an advertiser, and they worked so hard to get each of those advertisers, so I don't know. I mean, I assume this is somehow factored into Jack's plan somewhere, because otherwise it's a rather bonehead move. I think that the advertising piece is going to be a really big deal. But Adam's going to pull it. And, on a side note, every time I see Adam, I just want to rip his clothes off. I just want to see Adam. That's the only function he needs to serve from now on, is bedroom scenes with Heather. That's all I really care about, which is so surprising. I'm so surprised at myself, because, I mean, if you look at my early vlogs, I'm like, I hate Adam. And now I'm like, get naked. Yeah. So, I don't know. Okay. YouTube has this plain annoying 10-minute time limit on videos, so I'm going to end this right now and call it part one, and I'm going to post a second video to follow, so stay tuned, because man, there's still a lot more to talk about. I haven't actually updated my vlog in like 10 whole days, so I've got like 10 days of things to talk about, so stick with me. I will be right back.